So we want to address, first off, what is Geometer? So Geometer is a holistic design tool for creating, communicating, and manufacturing advanced human-scale forms. What that really gets down to is that it's a kit of robust physical and digital components which have unique names and specific geometry, which can be combined in a modular fashion. The system components also has a way of communicating their interactions, so you can communicate the complete design. And there is finally a physical way to manufacture these assemblies into large assemblies, and you can do it in a variety of materials. So the reason why we started doing this project is we realized that everyone wants things, and that a certain subset of individuals actually gather satisfaction from making things themselves. So much so that there's a growing DIY and makerspace community of people expanding out in the world, and this number of people is growing every day. So this has an interesting counter problem, though, that these people don't just want to make novelties, they want to make realistic, practical objects over gadgets. So they end up biting off a lot more than they can chew, and they start getting involved in these very high-level craft processes. They join these maker spaces with these elaborate tools, and they really don't know what they're getting into. So this is where we think that Geometer can actually help. So what we've done is optimize every module so that there is a primary reference component and open-ended mold, which can break up into multiple pieces and be reassembled. And these molds can be combined with one another and all of their, to allow for assemblies being made. So we took care of all the math, so you don't have to. So we thought about material minimums and how exactly these mates and connections work out. How do you communicate the rotation of one component to another? And all of these other very, very exciting and fun details that we can talk about outside if people are interested. So that way you can get to making things like this, or this, or this. From here, we want to talk a little bit about our network.
Yeah. So a recent graduate, Seth Matowski, he helped us really simplify this down and really helped us determine what was the best user experience here with what we're doing and what we're trying to do. Jeff Baer at PDI Furniture, another graduate. These guys really know their stuff, and they're really highly technical, but as far as making stuff, they've really helped us along in helping other people who want to join these spaces.
So we want to run through one hypothetical kind of use case. So our user of ours is definitely interested in the DIY maker scene, and they want to get more heavily involved. So they decide that they're going to join a local makerspace because they can't own every tool in the universe. So they end up going down to Next Fab, and they take a tour and go through the orientation. And while they're on tour, they find that they have access to a lot of different tools, many of which they've never used before. And they see things like plasma cutters and CNC machines. And they get to learn some of the drawbacks and benefits of all of these. Geometer is one of these many tools. So while they're on tour, they might see a box of Geometer components lying on a table somewhere and make a little mental note to themselves that this thing exists. And as they go along, they also get to experience the general work environment, kind of assistance that they can get from their communities and peer network. And they find out that some of these tools cost more money than others to operate. And so as they go through the training, they learn a little bit about woodworking. They may make a cutting board. That's one of the first products that they have you do in the wood shop. That's a lot of fun, but it's a cutting board. But they end up using the workspace. They end up using the workspace for a lot more than just making cutting boards. They find they have access to all sorts of complex software and a lot of resources they've just never really had access to before. And they find they really like working there. So one of the things they find while they're at Next Fab is just by chance on one of their lunch breaks that there's these little snap together modules. And so these are a little bit fun toys. So they play around with them. They make some interesting assemblies. These are half-scale modules. And pretty soon, people are like, oh, that's actually kind of an interesting formation you made there. Did you know hours that are required. And so they start looking into alternatives, and they find that on the computer, the folder that's pre-labeled Geometer, and they start checking out the files, and they find they can just drag and drop and start making assemblies. And they get pretty good at this pretty quickly.
So this is really cool. As somebody who's making some new tool, we also want to utilize the new tools of the future. This is Gravity Sketch. This is an example of somebody actually making something in it. These are three different examples of three different people making different things, and a fourth example at the end. This is Mindex. This allows us to use the primary tools of design that we use, SolidWorks and Rhino, to create those forms more technically. And then your standard way of making things that we all know, of just doing it in Rhino or SolidWorks. So another awesome part about this, keeping it open source, this allows us to make changes over time. We're on version 7.0, and that's through the feedback of the people online and offline. Really, this is something special to this because the library can then expand, people can then modify and build off of this, and it can exist beyond just where we are right now. And so, to go back to our storyline, Umbreaks, you know, they're working with this and getting better at the software, so they can make all sorts of things now. They get progressively better, and others are starting to notice, and somebody's making something. This is fun to make yourself, but it's even better to make with someone else, especially when it comes to pouring the mold. And assembling them while you're doing so. It's an artifact, it's really cool, and there's a certain satisfaction there. You might take a picture for the gram, and that is just another way that this can spread over through to the rest of the community, design or not. So casting allows us to do a lot of really cool different materials. An up-and-coming material that people are experimenting all sorts of ways in mycelium. So this is a really cool, lightweight material. Strength properties are right now are more along the packaging range, but if you were to make a big light that we showed you earlier, you could make a really big structure, but it wouldn't necessarily have to be the heaviest thing in the world. Going on to concrete, this was kind of the first kind of thing that really everybody was like, yes, gotta do some concrete if you're casting. And going on to an even better hydrocal, because hydrocal is way better than concrete for casting. Anyway, for making assemblies, we're using stainless steel clamps. Really one of the things we found that plastic's really great for forming and making this thing. But when it came to keeping things together, plastics, when you get into the minor details of things and keeping things together, things tend to break pretty easily. And so a really easily accessible, easily replaceable, and providing uniform strength all throughout the mold, we went with stainless steel clamps that can remove completely off and allow you to release. On to the next. And so disassembly, we have a unique fillet type that allows us to do a disassembly with a very complex structure. One of the things that we were running into with different types of fillets were the molds. You know, you'd end up, unless you were having some sort of depth angle, not coming apart very well in our modeling. And this allowed us to do it. And so, in summary, this builds to a certain type of skill translation. They translate easily to other practices and processes. The user can change their experience to retain the type of value. Makes it more convenient to make documentation, and open source makes it so that anybody can try it out with minimal effort, whether you start out digitally or physically. This combination of features put us in a class all of its own, more necessarily than the novelty of 3D printing, you know, that thing that you found on GrabCAD, or more accessible sending furniture piece designed to the boys in China. Learning specialized craft, and it's far cheaper than conventional small scale manufacturing. And so we wanted to say thank you so much, Eileen Martinson especially, that money helped so much, and everybody else, everybody who worked with us in VR as we're like just throwing this stuff at you, your feedback, this faculty for keeping us, you know, keeping us on our toes and keeping us accountable. And is there anybody else?